And welcome back. So last time we got all this glue, well, epoxied in and working. So now it's time to start working on this front. And I think the first thing I want to do is get the inside painted and then try get this stuck in place and epoxied. I think it's going to be a lot easier to paint this before I fit it than after. Gonna work on the lighting for this panel. I may have to order some more white SMDs. I'm not sure how many I've got in my stash at the moment. But before we get on with that, I forgot to show you this last time. I did paint where the hatch is going to go in the blue. As you can see, this would have been almost impossible to paint neatly after it was fitted. So I'm glad I did paint it up. And it also gives us an idea of what the colours are actually going to look like. So I'm going to get this painted, glued in place, probably epoxied as well, and then we'll have another look before I move on with whatever I do next on it. Right, so I've brought the camera down a little bit so we can see I have the front in place. This is all epoxied in all the way along to hold it really well. Clamped it all well. I'm not sure if we can get a really good light on this. You can see a little bit of a mark from where it joins, but it's actually not a great deal. So next things to do are, need to get the backlit panels in and the photo etch over them. We need to start looking at getting some lights in behind, and I think I'm going to use little SMDs. I think with them we'll be able to fit it all and light block it a lot easier. But I was looking at this, and it's something a lot of people have said. If you consider the finished model from the front, it's these two windows we'll see in through. And if I put two figures sat in chairs there, it's going to block a lot. So I'm really considering if I'll use the figures or not. I am going to paint them, I think, just as a good exercise anyway. But next up, it's either fitting the planes in here, getting all this sanded down and looking really excellently smooth with some primer on, and possibly paint the front, and the SMDs. I'm not sure which next, but whatever I get done, I will show you as soon as. Right, so we've been cracking on quite a bit. If you can't understand me very well, I apologise. I've had a load of dental work done this weekend, so I can't talk quite normal. What have we done? We've got the backlit panels in here and the photo etch on. We've got the decals over all these panels. I've also added a little lip of plastic to the bottom, and this is so we don't get a light leak when it's fitted in place. And if we have a look over some LEDs, you can see how all this lights up now. So next I'm gonna get SMDs fitted in here to light these panels, get it into the ship, and get the light blocking sorted at the bottom and we'll have another look. Right, as you can see, I've got all this control panel lit up now. I had to have a complete change of direction how I was going to light it. That's when I fitted my lights. I tried to do like just four SMDs so far down to shine through. And when I tried to fit it wouldn't fit. So I've had to go back and redo it. So there's literally an SMD behind each of these panels. And because I was doing that, I took the opportunity to make this one green, this one red. Let's happen to have some of them in as well. These are all stuck in, and I've painted it black to stop any light leak from the bottom. So I've got away with, I've removed that lip that I'd fitted. I've checked around here. I had a couple of light leaks on this panel. But I've filled them in, repainted it. So this is now ready to get attached into the sub. So I'll get this attached and we'll have a look at it in place. Okay, so the control panel is all in place. That looks like I've got a couple of little light leaks that I didn't realise I had. One above there. One above there. It's very difficult to get a camera angle because in the finished model, and this won't focus because it's focusing on this, but everything is going to be seen from that view. So we might actually get away without having to deal with them light leaks. But I'm really happy with how this is looking. I probably will address them just for my own peace of mind. Really pleased with how that's come out, how it's all fitted in place. So I think we'll call that a day for this video. Next time, I think what I want to do is get the headlights in place, the vents that go here, and the windscreen, and probably painted on the outside. That might change by the time I start making it, but we'll see. But for this time, thank you for watching. Keep trekking and keep modelling. Thank you. Goodbye.